the death of John McCain and what it means for Arizona politics, the exploding Lanny Davis-Michael Cohen affair, and the truth about immigration and crime. All this and more on this edition of Truth is Making a Comeback.
Truth is Making a Comeback. America's Top Stories with Lisa K. Donner.
With the passing of longtime Arizona Senator John McCain, the stakes are high in terms of whether the GOP can hold the Grand Canyon state in the upper chamber. Jeff Flake is out, and now McCain as well. There is educated speculation that Republican Governor Doug Ducey will appoint former Senator John Kyle to McCain's seat, which would safely put the so-called Maverick seat in Republican hands until 2020. Joining us to discuss this changing political landscape in Arizona is my better half and chief political columnist at Liberty Nation, Tim Donner. Thanks for joining us, Tim.
Thank you, Lisa.
Alrighty, let's spend a few minutes discussing McCain's legacy. How do you think he will go down in history?
Well, it depends who you ask. If you ask establishment Republicans or you ask Democrats, his legacy is well secure as a courageous maverick who was willing to separate himself from his own party in several instances. If you ask conservatives and Trump supporters, he's a turncoat, a guy who was never there when the Republicans really needed him, a guy who was an enemy, really, of Donald Trump and the last Republican president, George W. Bush, a man who, honestly, was not well-liked by his colleagues.
Give me, as a student of politics, your opinion of John McCain.
Well, as a student of politics, his career was fascinating. The way that he ascended to the Senate and was able to overcome an early being embroiled in the Keating Five banking scandal, something that would have ended the careers of many politicians, but he fought through it like he did everything in his life. No one can question that he was a battler to the end, as I said in my piece on libertynation.com.
Tim, do you think McCain was a man who allowed his personal flaws to seep into his political life?
Well, what we've discovered since his death is that this was a man with an anger issue from the time he was literally a toddler. The Chicago Tribune did an excellent piece on that. And his opponents, his political opponents, or those who challenged his point of view, were treated rudely at best. He was a black and white type of person. His opinion was white and yours was black if it was different than his. And that's why he was so broadly unpopular in the upper chamber of Congress.
So let's talk about the changing political landscape in Arizona now.
Well, the Republican governor of Arizona, Doug Ducey, is by state law the one who gets to name a replacement for McCain, and that person will remain in the Senate till 2020 when the seat comes up for election again. Now, Ducey is in a tough re-election fight of his own this fall, so who he picks to fill the Senate seat may have an impact on his own prospects. The question he faces is whether to appoint a McCain-style maverick Republican or a more mainstream conservative, but either way, that seat will remain in GOP hands for another 2 years.
Do you think it's likely he's going to pick former Senator John Kyle?
I think it's possible, though there's a reason that John Kyle retired from the Senate, because he had become sort of disgusted with the lack of activity in the Senate, the need for 60 votes, the highly partisan atmosphere that didn't allow much of any kind of legislation to pass, because whoever was proposing it, whether it be Obama or Trump, are getting no cooperation from those on the other side of the aisle.
Earlier this week, we had a primary election for Jeff Flake's seat. Tell us about the results of that.
Well, Jeff Flake, the other GOP senator from Arizona, is about as anti-Trump as McCain was, maybe even more. He's a certified never-Trump Republican who saw the handwriting on the wall on his own terribly low poll numbers and announced his retirement from the Senate months ago, or that he wouldn't face up to re-election. So now, without having to face the voters again, Senator Flake has been willing to make a number of statements criticizing the president, something he didn't do so much before he announced his decision not to run again. It was an intriguing race to replace Flake this fall. In the GOP primary this week, there was the establishment choice, Congresswoman Martha McSally, conservative stalwart Kelly Ward, and the famous or infamous 86-year-old Sheriff Joe Arpaio, the immigration hardliner who was convicted of criminal contempt and later pardoned by Donald Trump. McSally was victorious in the primary this week and will now face the Democrat Kyrsten Sinema in what's looking like a tight race.
Thanks so much for joining us today, Tim. That's Chief Political Columnist for LibertyNation.com, Tim Donner, reporting from Washington, D.C.
Truth is making a comeback. Visit us at LibertyNation.com.